So let us see what are the outcomes of today, this 10 minutes or 15 minute lecture. The first thing we are going to study about, we need to understand what are the cross-functional teams. So the first outcome of this lecture would be understanding cross-functional teams, how they work and what is the benefit, why we use cross-functional team and what actually the cross-functional teams are. This would be our first learning outcome. In the second learning outcome, we are trying to study about how these cross-functional teams are useful in new product development process and what are the main functions of new product development process and how these cross-functional teams are working together with other departments in making new product. And finally, we are looking at the determinants of these cross-functional team to be more effective. So what are the major ingredients or components or determinants we consider them as a successful interaction between the team. So that would be our third learning outcome. So let me take you to these three components one by one so we can easily understand on these points. So but remember, this video lecture is basically focused on three outcomes. The first one, learning or understanding the cross-functional teams. Second one, how they use or they are being used for new product development process. And finally, what are the measurements or determinants we can decide these cross-functional teams, they work efficiently or their effectiveness. So let me just take you through the first thing we discussed in the previous class also, but let me reassure you about the cross-functional team. What are the cross-functional teams? In the last class, we discussed very clearly that the functional departments are those which are categorized by their level of expertise or area of expertise. Each person in that functional department is expert of similar thing, like marketing. In the marketing department, everybody is working for marketing, and they are expert and their area of expertise must be marketing. Similar for the finance, product development and any other department. But for new product developments and advancement, especially for the radical innovations, we need the cross-functional team. We need the people with different skills, different expertises and different types of learning. So we need to combine them into a team that is called your cross-functional team. So this is how we try to develop new products and new ideas, rather they are innovative ideas in the form of incremental innovation or in the form of radical innovation. Both we need the cross-functional teams. So let me go to the next question from where we are going to start our class today. So why we need these cross-functional teams? What is their purpose? Think on this and you can comment right beside my video. So right down we will post the links, and also I'll try to create a blog for you so where you can share your information about the particular question. So just pause this video here and for a while, and as I always do in my class, so just explore yourself, not Mr. Google, just explore your mind and try to think why we need this cross-functional team. Why not? Functional structure is efficient because most of the traditional organization, they were working on the functional structures, but still we need cross-functional teams. So why they are more important, and especially in the terms of high-tech products, especially the industry related to the products and radical innovation, why these cross-functional teams are more important. So just pause here and think. I'm giving you 3 seconds to pause it. Let's move to the answer now. Because of product development, we need new ideas. A product, it is a combination of different departments from starting the concept up till the market where we sell these products. So from marketing to the product development, and then from product development to the prototypes, and then the product should be introduced to the market. So that is how new product has been introduced, and this is the process. But remember, this process required a cross-functional team approach. Not one particular product can be manufactured by simply one department, and not only manufacture, but we need to do the marketing part also. That is what we are here. Our subject is basically marketing related, where we are trying to see how we can market the new products, especially the high-tech products. So what are the procedures and what are the mechanisms? So first we need to understand the cross-functional teams, because everybody is different, everybody have the different expertise. They need to be merged into one team and try to develop something new. So this is how this is why we need to use cross-functional team in the high-tech marketing firm. But what are the characteristics we need to ensure that the new teams have successfully developed the new products? So we need to understand some of the basic parameters, the basic components or characteristics of any team where we need to develop new products. The first thing, the top management's commitment. Remember, the top management commitment for these cross-functional teams are very important. Let me give you a very practical example. Remember, in the cross-functional team, the people are working basically from the different departments, and they are being combined for a particular project or a particular product or any innovative idea to work together. So basically they are from functional department, but then they are working on some particular project. So that's why they are working under the cross-functional teams. Remember, these teams are very efficient, but to form these teams, we need to divert from the normal or traditional processes in the organization. So that's why it needs organizational top management commitment, especially in terms of finance, especially in terms of resources, in terms of flexibility, in terms of many other processes related to monitoring and control. So these are the main components for any cross-functional team. So these can be provided by the top management. If the top management is willing to invest in research and development, willing to invest in the cross-functional team and try to develop some radical innovations, and that may be, you know, as we mentioned in the previous classes, this radical innovation may fail in the market and may be succeeded. So this risk taking cannot be done without the top management commitment. So the first element I'm telling you is the top management's commitment related to the cross-functional team or successfully develop new product. The second component is the clear vision. Why we are here? What type of innovations we are doing? Why we are working together? What would be our common objective? And what is the vision of this cross-functional team? Maybe we are working together for some time, or maybe in some cases we work together for 5 years or more than 5 years. So let us clear our vision for this particular cross-functional team. We need to make a clear vision. What is our objective? What is the goal of this cross-functional team? When they join together and they disband, between this process, what are their working? What are their activities? What is the responsibility of each individual related to his or her expertise? And then how they are going to be integrated, because everyone is different and they are coming from the different department. So we need to understand they have to work together, but this working together is obviously with the different people. Maybe the conflict, they have some functional or relationship conflict that we talk about these conflicts later, but that is a part of this process. So we need to give them a very clear vision. The team which perform well, the first thing they need to understand the objective, why they are working together, what is their purpose. So in all form of innovation or innovative products, we need to clarify the vision of each of these team members. Let me share one example with you. We know that Sony Walkman is one of the most innovative products of its era. The CEO of Sony, he was working with these two teams, the functional department of design, and the other department was basically production. The one department was basically working for the stereo cassette players, and the other department, they were working for the speakers, something which they can carry out, or maybe limitize the connectivity. They were trying to develop something which basically should be remotely used, or maybe just with the wire for the speaker type. So what happens one day, the Sony CEO, he was traveling through his walking through, we call it management by wandering CEO. So he was walking through his different departments and trying to see and mingle up with the people and trying to see what they are doing. First he went to design or manufacturing department of this cassette player, and he asked the people, what are you doing nowadays? They said, okay, we are trying to develop a cassette player that is reduced, we are trying to reduce the size, because if you remember, the cassette player was very heavy on that time. But they said, we are trying to reduce the size of the cassette player without compromising the quality and efficiency. So that is how it started. He thought, okay, good, so you continue your work. And then he went to the next door where the audio player or the speakers are, they are working on that. And then he asked, okay, what are you doing nowadays? What type of products you are working? And their R&D department, they replied that we are trying to see how we can develop something in terms of the speakers, and we can use without the other equipment, or maybe we can just connect with any type of equipment with the cable. So that is how he was trying to learn from the different department. And then when he went back and he thought about it, why not we connect these two departments together and develop some product which may be usable for all the world. Then it was the invention of Sony Walkman, the product everybody knows that. So this is how different departments, he joined them, he did so many meetings, and then give them a clear vision, okay, this is what you need to develop, so work on it. So that is how different departments, they can work together. The similarly, you can see the situation around now, the coronavirus outbreak. We need cross-functional teams on this also. So this is how this different vaccination are being developed and tested over the year. Let's say some group of scientists is working in America, and some group of scientists is working in Netherlands, and some working in Malaysia. If they are working on the similar project again and again, this is the wastage of time and resources. If they collaborate together and define their activities and level of experiment they are doing, hopefully they can develop this vaccination more easily or more quickly. That is why the scientists, I was just listening to the news, they said we can develop this vaccination in 1 year. The normal vaccination process may take 3-4 years, but they said with these coordinated activities we can develop this vaccination within 1 year. So this is how we should be clear about the vision of the cross-functional team, and then the interaction between the people, what are the responsibilities of each individual. The third thing, improvisational approach. Remember, it's not always you have been given to the excellent resources. We need to work under the umbrella of organization. We need to work the resources available for the organization, and we need to work with the people available for those projects. So we cannot get the maximum or maybe the super facilities for every project. So that is what we need to do. We need to invest our thinking, our skills to improvise existing resources. So not all the time you can get the resources, whatever is required. So improvisation approach is the basics of cross-functional team. Improvisation in terms of different method, improvisation in terms of different resources, and even your relationship with the other. So development, it will come with the improvisation approach. So you need to see the cross-functional team, they need to, or we need to inculcate this improvisation approach in with between them. Then the sharing of information, it should be in continuation from the starting till the end of the product development and then marketing and all this. So remember, I explained in the previous lecture, there are two types of the products we are dealing with. The first, we call it incremental innovation, where we take information from the customers and try to improve our products. Office 2016-20 is a new product, but if you remember, it started with Office 2007, 95, 96. All these product versions are basically improvement from the previous products. But this improvement came through the information they receive from the customer. Every time you receive any error or any problem with the Office, they will ask you to report. And when you report, they try to develop improvements, or we call it incremental innovation. But at the same time, if you try to use the expertise of these cross-functional team and try to think beyond the conventional way of getting input from the customer, rather than try to predict their needs, the future needs, we can go with the radical innovation, where you can generate or develop new ideas and new products. So many of these radical innovations have been done in the past, and that is how we do. But this all things are possible when you have this information sharing culture in your cross-functional team. So whenever the cross-functional teams are working together, information sharing, it should be in continuation from step one up till the step when we develop complete product and start marketing for that. And the final one, the collaboration under pressure, very important factor. As I mentioned in this clear vision part, we can have conflicts. Obviously, we are working with the people, with the human beings, then the conflicts may be very much possible or likely to happen. So what we need to do when we have the different types of conflicts? I explained earlier, the conflicts may be of two types, broader category. There are many other types are available, but we can convert them into functional and relationship. When we have conflicts over the method of doing something, that is called functional conflict. We try to generate new ideas. We try to generate different types of methods to solve a similar problem. That is called your functional conflict. But at the same time, I explained to you in the past class, if you don't like me and I don't like you, I will not listen whatever you are trying to say. This is called a relationship conflict. And sometimes relationship conflict, it overcomes your functional conflict. So that will create a problem. So we are dealing with people, will try to encourage functional conflict and try to reduce the levels of relationship conflict in the cross-functional team. But remember, these conflicts may be the need of your future. It create a pressure between the team members, between the cross-functional teams. Remember, I gave you example of this COVID-19 now. Now everybody is working under the pressure. You can see the world is locked down. Everybody is trying to secure himself. And we are, as a human being, we are scared of each other too. It's an intense pressure situation. And think about those scientists who are working on creation of this vaccination for this coronavirus. Remember, it's a lot of pressure, but the ability to work under the pressure will determine the level of expertise you have. Your cross-functional team, how much they are capable of working under the pressure. So try to encourage your functional conflict and try to reduce the dysfunctional conflict. That would be the major portion of your cross-functional team ability. If you can do that, your team can work under pressure. That means that they are best team you have. So try to reduce this relationship conflicts. Okay, let's move